Findings by Habitat for Humanity, Uganda, show that the country's housing deficit stands at 2.4 million housing units, out of which 210,000 units are in urban areas and 1.4 million units are in rural areas, with an estimated 900,000 units being substandard and in need of replacement or upgrading.
The government of Uganda decided to have a private sector-led economy. And so the housing sector is really, like all other, the other sectors in the economy, are private sector led. The role of government would be to provide a conducive policy, legislation, and regulatory framework, and also to monitor the implementation of such framework.
As Uganda embarks on National Development Plan 3, it is necessary to plan for sustainable housing in the new cities for all demographics, considering projections that by 2022, Uganda's population will be at about 48 million people.
But you find that many times we challenge the fact that because of the urban sprawl, the large rural urban migration, we are not able to control all these developments.
There is huge demand for housing. There is huge population explosion, people moving towards the cities. And if these cities are not well planned, then there is going to be chaos.
Whichever way you look at it, is if we can try and create and build cities and develop properties and provide, bring online products that are also sympathetic and cognizant of the fact that the world is going to go on long after us.
Sector developers like Aesthetics Designs have embarked on construction of housing in urban areas like Chisasi, Chiwatule and Kulambiro. They recognize NDP3's key objective to plan and manage urban growth amidst high urbanization rates.
It has given us a lot of freedom in creativity. So the most striking difference is the ground cover or the green coverage which people get. It's not only the apartments which they buy, but it's also the different landscape terraces, the communal spaces, and most important aspect is the concept of work from home. So these projects respond to that, okay, because COVID taught us that the work culture is going to change drastically.
The new cities, Arua, Gulu, Jinja, Mbarara, Fort Portal, Mbale and Masaka, are part of the growing need for urban planning where both government and private sector players are in the spotlight on how best they will manage the task at hand. Wadulo Mark Arnold, UBC News.